Okay, I'm here today at CAR&DRIVER's road and track Hyundai Turbo Sonata and Hyundai Turbo Veloster test drive event. And I'm basically going to test drive both of these cars, and I'm going to put two videos onto my page. So let's see how that goes. And I brought today with me this little dock so I can hold my camera up into the window. Okay. So this is what it looks like. It's just like the orange one that I had a while back. Now, I heard this car comes in matte black paint. This one's obviously not matte black. I think they also have a matte gray. It's got some pretty aggressive wheels. It's got a pretty soft startup, you know. But looks pretty good. Now this guy who just got in here is a pretty big guy. So I already know the Veloster's got some decent space in it. Oh, okay, they have their own cameras. They got mine. It's pretty cool. It's a Sonata Turbo. You know, what they should have done was done this like a long time ago, because these cars are already on the market. Because these cars are already on the market, a lot of people already bought them. They should have done this event like months ago. This, I get a little badge in order to do my test drive for CAR&DRIVER. So now I'm officially in the party. These lovely ladies sign people up. And this is registration. And here are the cars that we're going to drive today. So this is the Turbo Sonata. And that's the, obviously, Veloster Turbo. But they don't have the matte black, they don't have the matte paint version. I wanted to actually touch the matte paint, but they don't have that version here. Now, I already wrote a review about this car, so I'm going to put the review URL on my the comment section. Yeah, it's a Sonata. I always like this car. This is a really nice start for Honda. I wish they had brought the Genesis R spec. It would have been really nice to have the Genesis here, because to tell you the truth, the regular Genesis and the regular Genesis and the regular Sonata and the regular Veloster are probably the best cars Hyundai has, because a lot of people really don't want to pay the extra money for the the gas, you know, because right now gas is like damn near $4 and something for premium, and if you have a Veloster Turbo, if you have a Sonata Turbo, you got to buy premium fuel. Get me a soda right here. Ooh, they got oats and honey. Oh, banana. I think I'll get a banana. Nah, I'll get one of these. I love these events. I just love them. Let me get some coffee. Oh, this has a panoramic roof on it, huh? That's cool. Type back there. Manual. Oh, okay. This is the Turbo Veloster. Turbo Veloster. Okay, so this is what I'm driving first, the Sonata 2.0T. Most people are pretty much familiar with the Sonata. It's decent. It has back seat space. Now, only small adults can really get into this thing. I mean, you can be tall and ride up front, but see, as soon as you start pushing the chair back, you lose a lot of space up front.
All right.
All right, how you doing?
Pretty good, thanks for your patience.
Cool, yeah, no problem. All right.
We're gonna go that way.
All right.
You got the backup camera as well, so okay. This is the limited version, so it's got everything.
Okay. Oh, that's my good. Oh, it's got some pickup.
Yeah, it's the turbo is like it's peppier than most people realize.
It's got low end pickup. That feels good. It feels even feels better than the regular one for the low end. Wow.
And we're gonna exit right here, and then we can left at the end of the driveway.
Okay.
And through this whole thing, you know, I would just get your candid feedback on anything that you might like or dislike about the car.
Okay, once we get outside of the, what is it called, the gate, what I'm going to do is just check and see what the torque steer is like. So here we got the straightaway. Let me just see. Oh, okay, that's not bad. The wheel didn't even turn. The wheel didn't turn at all. It's not bad at all. It's pretty cool.
It's not like a Mazda Speed 3.
Everybody loves that Mazda RX-5, but it's too small. It's just, I mean, you know, unless you're like, you can't have a family in there. I mean, this is seems to be pretty good, like, space-wise, like, if you don't really want to compromise, like, between having enough space for four people. The only two-door car I really like is a CTS-V coupe.
Gotcha.
I don't even really like the CTS-V sedan. I like that coupe though. I love that car. Mm. But it's like I'm like 6'6", so it's like for me it doesn't make sense.
Now how does
this thing feels good?
How does it compare to your SRT8?
Okay, well let's see about that because I don't know, have you ever driven one of those before?
Yes, I have.
In the stock form.
Yeah.
This car, all right, it did feel a little torque steer right there. In the stock form, my car gets to 60 quicker, but this is pretty fast though.
For a four-cylinder.
Yeah, for a four-cylinder, this is pretty fast. Now, here's a question. You have to use, what is it, premium in this?
No, regular gas is fine.
But in order to get max turbo, you got to use premium.
Yeah, I probably would. Any turbo car, I would put nothing less than 91.
Does it get, like, lower gas mileage if you don't use premium?
Not necessarily, but turbo's, like higher octane. Just because it runs, you know, less detonation, doesn't lean out as much.
Mm-hmm.
Do you guys have 93 octane here?
93?
Yeah.
Yeah. In fact, 93 is what most of the gas stations have.
Gotcha.
Most of them, it's actually, you got like, what's the highest you get?
We'll get, that's his stop sign.
Oh, okay.
All right. The highest we get is 91, and it's crappy 91.
Hyundai is their client.
Hyundai is their client,
we're,
okay.
We're kind of facilitating staffing, insurance, and all that kind of thing.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I always liked the look of this Veloster. The first one that I drove was an orange one, but it was the regular one. But I like the interior work they did on the seats, and it looks really good. I like these seat trims. I like the blue seat trims a little bit better, but this is okay too. You can't get the blue seat trims on the blue car?
Yeah.
I like this ultra panel roof is like this extra or
Yes.
It is extra. So how much extra?
I don't know. I'd have to find out.
Oh, okay.
So tell me about how your impressions of Hyundai have been changed by driving today or
I'm gonna find out right now about
okay.
this car.
Okay.
Like for instance, with the Sonata, it stopped right here and I was gonna basically see how fast it accelerates because I've been hearing some people were complaining that this one's not as fast as the Sonata and yeah you know at that low end it takes some time to get up right now we're at 40 50
and it's
not quite 60 just yet. I'll wait till the next major straightaway, but that low end acceleration, it takes time for it to get up. The Sonata gets right up.
And that's the difference between the 1.6 and 2 liter and the difference between 201 and a 274 horsepower.
But here's a question. Why does this car weighs more than the Sonata though?
No.
No, it doesn't.
I don't believe so.
Okay.
But I don't think the weight to horsepower, I think it's got less horsepower per pound.
But here's my problem. Why bother downsizing the engine though? Why not just leave it a 2.0?
Fit.
It wouldn't fit in this car?
It may not. I don't know. I mean, I don't engineer it. I don't know.
Okay, so I'm going to do 0 to 60. That's 20, 40, 50, 60. Okay. It doesn't seem slow, but the low end pickup is just a little sluggish on that low end.
Right.
So I do understand what they're talking about. Meanwhile, that Sonata, it almost feels like a V6.
Right.
You know, I do see what they're saying.
Well, it's a different car, different market, different feel.
And it's very racy, but maybe they did that on purpose. I don't know. Maybe they tried to give it a throaty sound or something, because I noticed how those exhaust pipes aren't like the ones on the Sonata, so maybe they did that on purpose.
Suspension feel, chassis feel.
Now, the roads here in New Jersey are perfect roads. So there's almost no bumps. It feels pretty good. I don't feel much torque steer at all. Feels pretty good. There's not very many bumps, but it's not harsh at all. I can see that. It doesn't. The steering wheel gives you absolutely no feedback, but then it's a front wheel drive, so that's not a big deal. That's like standard. But I can't feel the road at all through the wheel. I can't feel it. The road is dead.
Okay.
Like I drive mostly rear wheel drive cars, so I see that right away. There's no bump steer. You don't feel the road at all. Which I guess some people, if they drive front wheel drive cars, they're used to it, so they don't really care. But other than that, brakes are pretty good. They're not too grabby. The brakes feels pretty strong. Are these performance brakes?
They are.
What kind are these?
I'm not sure. We're gonna have to turn right at the light.
It's not bad. It's really not bad. The one thing I don't like about this car is the three doors. They could have put four doors in this car. They really could. I think it would have been a little bit nicer if it had four doors. Because the thing about it is, like, if it was me, if I had a child seat,
mm-hmm.
and I was going to put it right behind me, the only problem is if you get into, like, a crash or something and you got to get to that seat, it might be a problem trying to get to that seat, you know, if it's really hard to get out of this side. But,
right.
You know, that probably hasn't happened yet. So, you know, that's just speculation. It's a pretty...
What do you think about the fit and finish? Talk to me about fit and finish portions.
Love the seat trims. Love the ultra view roof. What Sonata really would have made me happier is if they had heated and cooled seats, just like they have in the Kia Optima. Because that's one thing that I noticed, like the Sonata is supposed to be the higher end. I don't make a rare.
No.
The Sonata is supposed to be the higher end one, yet the Kia has more features. The Kia Optima has heated cooled seats. And that's something that I absolutely must have. It's like as soon as I get in the car, I just turn it right on.
Right.
You know? Because it allows me to turn my air conditioner lower, and I still feel really comfortable.